In this video, I will explain about a differentiator amplifier using op-amp 741. This is circuit diagram of differentiator. It consists of op-amp IC 741. At the input, we have connected a capacitor and a resistor. It is in series. And in the feedback, we have connected a capacitor. Its value is 0.01 microfarad. And a feedback resistor, and its value is 1.59 kilo ohm. Once we connected the resistors and capacitor in this fashion, then this circuit works as differentiator. Here at the pin number 2, we have to apply the input with the help of function generator, and at the pin number 6, we have to observe the output. What kind of input we apply in the input? At the input, we have to give the square wave, and at the output we will obtain these spikes. Now let's see how to construct this circuit on breadboard. On breadboard, here we can see that this is the input, this is the input resistor, and a capacitor is connected to pin number 2, and in the feedback the pin number 2 and pin number 6 having a capacitor and resistor. And before we observe the output, we should also apply the voltages. Here I am using operational amplifier power supply. It is having three terminals, that is plus 15, minus 15 and ground. The plus 15 I have connected to pin number 7 of 741, and the minus 15 is connected to pin number 4 of the IC, and the ground is connected to ground of the circuit. Now I will apply the input with the help of function generator. This is the function generator. Here we have to select the square waveform. With the help of this button, I can change the waveform. Here I have, with the help of this waveform button, I can change the waveform. I have set as square wave here. I have set as a square wave, and I have to set the frequency as 1 kilohertz. I will change its frequency to 1 kilohertz. Or 1.5 kilohertz, and we have to set the input voltage as 1 volt. That can be changed with the help of this knob, that is amplitude knob. And in CRO, we have to observe the output. Here we are getting the output of differentiator amplifier. Now, first we will check the input in CRO. With the help of this BNC connector, I will connect this red pin to pin number 2 or the input of function generator. That is here at resistor, I will connect this at the input. I have connected this to input. Here we can observe that we are getting the square wave. Let's set this time division properly. Here we can see that this is the square wave. Measure its amplitude as well as the frequency. Its amplitude is, here we can see that it is of 1 here I am measuring the voltage of input. It is of total height is, from here it is 1 division, 1 into the division per volt is 1, that turns out to be total 1 volt, and the frequency is here. Total from here we have to check 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 into the 50, here it is of 0.1 millisecond. Here it is 4 division into 0.1 millisecond, that turns out to be 4 into 0.1 millisecond. It is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4 is a time. When I make 1 divided by this value, that is 2.5 kilohertz, but it should be 1.5 because this we have to keep maximum, hence we are getting wrong reading here. I will check it once again. Now measure it once again. 1, 2, 3, 3.6. 3.6 into 0.2 millisecond. 7.2 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Make it 1 divided by this value. Here we can see that we are getting almost 1.4 kilohertz as the input. And we have already measured the input voltage. Now we will check its output. In order to check the output, we have to connect the CRO positive at the pin number 6 here. I will connect this to pin number 6 in the circuit diagram. In the circuit, I have connected here. Here we can observe that in CRO, we can observe that when I give the square wave, we obtain the spike. We will get a negative spike for T on positive, and we will get a positive spike for T off of the square wave. In this way, we conduct the differentiator circuit with the help of op-amp.